Because better allocate for 8 elements, that's why we have enough memory, and then we disallocate or called destructor for our allocator. But when we have two vectors, we create two allocator, because each allocator is for each vector with each type that use vector, and we create two instance for allocator, but it's same allocator, we use same memory and same implementation, and we have same problem with when we use different types. And also it decrease compile time, because compiler needs generate code for a new type, but we do same, we just allocate and disallocate memory. What news in C++ 17? We have polymorph allocator, memory resource, and some alias for STL containers. And in C++, C++ 70 example, we will see we just use some resource and we set resource in each vector. I use the default resource that use operator new delete and pass it with two containers. So let's see in details. If we compare SD allocator and polymorph allocator, first of all, a lot of items in SD allocator was marked as deprecated and will be deleted in 17.12. Also, they look similar. Both can allocate and deallocate memory. But what is different? As you can see, both have default constructor, copy constructor, but polymorph allocator take memory resource and allocate using this resource. Let's see what is memory resource. It's very simple class. The just three public method, allocate, deallocate, and is equal. The called by allocators, and three functions, the pur virtual function. And let's create custom memory resource. We need just override function doallocate, do deallocate, and do is equal. Those functions look like similar like in std allocator, but now we don't depend on type and return void. So in std allocator we create compiler will generate new class for each type, but they do same, and now we don't depend on type. And how to use in our containers. In C++ 70 was added also alias for containers. For example, instead use the vector type polymorph allocator T, we can use just alias as the PMR vector. And how will look our example with our allocator. So we create our memory resource and pass in our vector. And you can see same similar output like in SD allocator. We allocate, deallocate, and implementation look like, output look like similar, but when we have two vectors, we just place same resource, and we don't have each instance for each vector, and we have like similar implementation, and you can manage this manner of manage memory for each for both container. Also, in C++ 70 was added some standard resources, like new delete resource. It's used just operator new delete, new memory resource. These resources don't allocate memory and throw exception when you try to allocate something. No, unsynchronized pool resource, it's not three safe allocation and deallocation. Synchronized pool resource, no, it's synchronized. And sorry, and monotonic buffer resource, it allocate memory, but don't allocate after each call deallocate. It deallocate only one time. So let's discuss about monotonic buffer in more details. So first, we have several pool with several chunk amount. Yeah, each pool have some chunk with same size. It's chunk, and so we need space for some object. this object is bigger 415.6 and less 512.20. And so we will use this pool. So we need find list with free chunk. So we analyze this list, then we analyze this, and we found that this chunk is free. So we put object it, for example, in this chunk. For next object, when this list is full, we allocate new list with chunk, and new list is twice as much previous list, and we allocate some list when we face this limit max block size per chunk. You can set this size, and also you can set size with pool. So if we face this limit, or we will when we face this limit, we allocate memory from upstream allocator. So why one of the important things is memory resources don't allocate when object is deleted, or when container delete object, or when we call deallocate. So for example, when we delete this object, we don't change list or chunk. We release memory when we delete all resource. Why it needs? Why is this need? it help reduce fragmentation in RAM. What does mean? Each process work with virtual memory. It can be like physical memory of disk if we use swap. Memory in RAM shared between several processes. For example, it's for one process, for other process, and for current process. And you can see some defragmentation in memory. And when you allocate big space, you reserve its space in RAM, and often it will block without any different mutation. And when you iterate during this block, process can cache some part of this block. So, and you reduce different mutation, you increase cache. No, you increase some part of your memory in CPU cache, and it's increase performance. So sometimes it's very important when you just allocate memory, but don't often deallocate memory. So summary, compare implementation as allocators bit before C++ 17, and we review how we use resource memory in start from C++ 17, create simple implementation for it, and review monotonic buffer resource. So, do you have any question? I think no. So, if you will have question, you can ask me directly.